Let's talk about the last video I posted on shipping container homes. It obviously triggered a lot of people, but hey, at least I was called a lady. A lot of people were bent out of shape because of the S word in the title and called it clickbait, despite the entire video being exactly what the title said it was. I presented 7 logical arguments against them from a design and construction perspective, from my perspective, and I justified my position on the topic and the title too. But people couldn't seem to grasp the fact that I was just raising important issues that aren't discussed. And you know what? If I had used any other title, people would have complained about that one too. There are hundreds of YouTube videos glamorizing shipping containers, but not enough talking about their drawbacks and questioning their validity. How are we going to improve things as a society if we don't question the way things are done and push to find something better? I realize that shipping containers are doing that in a way because they are questioning standard suburban home ownership and proposing an alternative. But I was just questioning whether that step is enough or if we should be looking for a better alternative. The reaction I got to that video just proves that once you've drunk the Kool-Aid, you are unable to see past what you've been told. I received a ridiculous amount of cyber-stalking, racist and sexist comments and harassment and bullying over a freaking YouTube video. And I expected it and I was prepared for it, but it still took me by surprise. I guess people just don't realize that if you don't like something or if you don't agree with it, you can simply move on. There is no way you're going to please everyone and you shouldn't live your life trying to. Anyway, after sifting through all that garbage, I got some pretty interesting feedback that needed further explanation, so I'm going to go through some of them. I'm not going to be naming anyone while doing this. The first thing is that I'm threatened to lose business as an architect because self-builders can now build their own homes. Okay, if you have built your own home, whether it's a container home or not, good for you. If you plan on building your own container home in the future, good for you. I hope it works out and I wish you the best of luck. I am not preventing you from building your container home, but there's a distinction between a self-build by an amateur and something done by an expert. This applies universally to all fields, but I'm going to be using the analogy of woodworking. I have built a dresser, TV stand, a dining table, a coffee table, just basic furniture. They work just fine. I am proud of them and they're functional, but a fine woodworker who is an expert tradesperson wouldn't approve. They believe that there's an art to wood construction and I have ignored essential details. The same thing applies to home building. You can build your own container home. You'll be proud of your accomplishment and it will be functional. But I'm saying that there's a distinction between a self-build by an amateur and a home that's built to last by experts. There's a science to home building. There's a reason behind architectural design. There's a reason behind construction details. What concerns me is the amount at stake with a home build compared to a simple woodworking project. Your life, your health, your financial future is at stake. So no, I am not threatened to lose business. I am questioning the science behind container home construction. Next up, insulation on the inside is a bad idea. A fellow designer left a very insightful comment agreeing with me that insulating a container home is very tricky. Water is the main enemy of a building. In typical construction, when you have metal siding, you have an air gap or drainage space and then a drainage plane for water and condensed vapor to escape. Then you have exterior sheathing, structural members like wood or metal studs, insulation, and then interior finishes like drywall. With a container home, people eliminate the air gap, the drainage plane, and stick insulation directly to the corrugated metal on the inside, or you spray foam. The wood studs that you use inside the container butt up against the corrugated metal, so they act as a thermal bridge. This means that there's a huge temperature difference at the metal cladding and it can cause massive condensation inside the home, which is now the drainage plane. This is ignoring basic construction science. The logical thing to do is to insulate the exterior so that the drainage plane is now the exterior corrugated metal cladding. This is a legitimate concern because if you don't insulate your home properly, it can cause toxic black mold to grow. I was very glad to have fellow designers and architects agree with me on this issue. Another one is you aren't cutting down trees, so it's more environmentally friendly. Where do you think steel comes from? You have to extract iron ore, purify it, create an alloy, melt it down into sheets, etc. An enormous amount of energy is expended in this process. You aren't directly cutting down trees, but you are burning fossil fuels for the process. I'm not saying that wood construction doesn't have a carbon footprint, but wood sequesters carbon, unlike steel. They are both incredibly useful, obviously, but wood is a renewable resource. You can't just associate deforestation with wood construction. You can sustainably harvest wood, use rapidly growing trees, plant new ones when you cut them down. It's ridiculous to discount its value because you associate cutting down a tree with a 2x4 or timber post. Of course, steel has the advantage of being recyclable, but recycling itself has a carbon footprint. For every container you pull out of service to build your container home, another one is made to replace it. Suburban homes are a scam. At no point did I say that typical suburban homes are a better option. I live in Dallas, where $500,000 homes are constructed with finger-jointed studs and cardboard sheathing. I think that's ridiculous. I question how long those homes are going to last, and their quality seems really cheap to me. But again, the people building it say that it works. The people living in them are happy for now. To me, it seems like a short-term way of building, and it isn't sustainable. But as long as there's a demand for those type of homes, builders will continue to plop them down and suburban sprawl will worsen. But I don't see how container homes can be the solution to this problem. So for all of you who left those comments, your perspective on tract homes is along the same lines as my perspective on container homes. Next up, I am against the tiny home movement. I'm a minimalist who believes in the tiny home movement. I don't see the point of owning a 3,000 square foot home for a family of three. I think home ownership is a trap, and I'm all for building small and living simple because that's what I practice. But I believe you can achieve that with a home most suitable to human proportions. This again goes back to the science of design. I'm questioning whether an 8 foot by 8.5 foot by 40 foot box is suitable for human habitation. Another comment was, you are starting with the skin of the home and building inward. I think that is a great summary of a container home. Working within constraints is great in certain instances because it forces you to be creative. But when it comes to fine home building, you are shooting yourself in the foot if you start with the skin of the home because you cannot detail it out properly. When they construct those fancy luxury container homes you see on social media, they probably tear out the siding to build the exterior walls first and then weld the siding back on. Every detail is unnecessarily difficult because you are starting with the corrugated skin in place. Let's take window details for example. You can technically cut a hole in the corrugated siding, stick a window in there and caulk all the edges and be fine with the end result. If that works for you, great. But if you're trying to construct a well-built home, you have to consider window flashings, a sloped sill, vapor movement through diffusion, etc. Next up, cost. Directly comparing the cost of a 3,000 square foot home versus a 300 square foot home isn't logical. It is obviously going to be cheaper to build a container home. And again, if you want to go down that path, go ahead, good for you. People accused me of wanting them to be stuck with home mortgages and not wanting them to have a place to live. 30-year mortgages are a scam. Build small, live within your means, don't build up a debt. Lower your footprint, live off solar power, it's all good. You can still do that with a sturdy timber frame home or a structural steel framed home. There are better alternatives there to achieve your end result. Be cautious of getting caught up in this container home fad when it might not be the best option for you. Next, they're hurricane resistant. A 40-foot shipping container weighs 8,000 pounds. So yes, they're hurricane resistant. But you don't have to resort to building heavy to withstand natural disasters. Take Japan for example. They need to design earthquake-resistant buildings because of the seismic activity in the country. And they have come up with some very creative solutions. They have damping systems at their foundations. They design seismically isolated structures. In the same way, we don't have to resort to building heavy in hurricane-prone regions or in Tornado Alley where I live. Structural steel and timber homes are very resilient and can provide a flexibility in design that container homes cannot. They're also not as heavy, so you're going to save money on your foundation. Okay, I'm going to end it here. what I hope you take away from this is to be open to other points of view, especially when presented logically. If you can't, then move on. There are hundreds, if not thousands, of pro shipping container videos and channels out there. I'm going to release a video showcasing some successfully retrofitted shipping containers tomorrow, so I hope you check that out. Don't let people get you down, whether they are faceless strangers on the internet or people in your life. It's not worth it. Anyway, thanks for watching. See ya.